everyone, in this video I'll be discussing F12 and the formation of pairs. Even though I will be going over some basic F12 concepts, this video is not meant to be a tutorial and I will not be explaining some things such as the use of empty slots. So I recommend that you have at least a little prior knowledge on the topic beforehand. Even if you know a decent amount about F12, this video may be helpful to you, especially if you'll be watching the rest of the series, as it may give you a different way of approaching F12. Also know that I will not be teaching you every F12 case in this video. Instead, I will explain certain ideas and give you some examples, then I'll talk about how you should teach yourself the rest of the cases. That said, let's get into it. First of all, triggers, which are basically short 3-4 move algorithms, are essential to all of F12. Throughout this entire series, I'll be referring to the following triggers repeatedly, so really make sure you know them well. You will likely know most, if not all of them already. The triggers are RU R prime, RU prime R prime, RU2 R prime, and R prime F R F prime, which it should be noted is often referred to as a sledgehammer. You should also know the mirrors of all these triggers, which are L prime U prime L, L prime U L, L prime U2 L, and L F prime, L prime, F, which also can be executed from this angle as F, R prime, F prime, R, which is just the inverse of a sledgehammer. Keep in mind that for the rest of this series, I won't talk very much about these mirrors, but understand that all the same concepts apply to them. If we take a systematic approach to solving any F12 pair, then our first goal is to set up the two pieces that make up that pair such that they are in one of these two positions or their mirrors. When they're set up like this, it's very easy to insert the pair just like this or like this. So that simplifies things a little. Now all we need to worry about is getting the pieces into one of those setups. For every F12 case in which at least one of the pieces that makes up the pair is in the top layer, you can set up the pieces into one of those four positions by using one of the triggers that I already showed you. To clarify, you may have to adjust the top layer before and or after executing the trigger depending upon the case, and the trigger that you do is not random and is also dependent on the F12 case. For example, one solution to this case is R, U prime, R prime, which is one of the triggers, then U2, an adjustment of the U face or AUF, then R, U, R prime to insert this pair. Also know that there is often more than one way to set up the pieces in this way, and thus usually more than one good solution to every case. Knowing multiple solutions to a single case can be very helpful in multi-slotting, partial edge control, and also just inserting that pair from different angles. Another solution to the same case is U2, an AUF, then R, U, R prime, a trigger, and you can see that these pieces are now paired up, so we can do U, R, U prime, R prime to insert this pair. Cases in which neither of the pieces that make up a pair are in the top layer are slightly different. For these cases, you must first execute one of the triggers to move both pieces into the top layer. Then you must solve the resulting case as you normally would. For instance, here I would do RU R prime to take these pieces out of the bottom middle layers where they were, and I'm now left with this case, which I can solve with U prime, RU2 R prime, another U prime, then RU R prime to finally insert the pair. Now you should understand the basic structure of forming F12 pairs. Of course though, the question still remains of how to know which trigger to do for each case. If you want the most efficient solution to each case, you honestly just have to memorize them. However, there are different ways of doing this, some of which may be more effective for you in particular than others. One way is the following. As I've already stated, when solving a pair, your first goal should be to get the pieces that make up the pair into one of these two positions. However, there are also four positions that the last layer can have, so really, you just want to get the pieces into one of these eight setups or their mirrors, then you should be able to insert the pair with ease. Knowing this, you can, from each of these eight setups and their mirrors, do the inverse of each of the triggers. When you do one of these, the result is an F12 case in which at least one of the pieces that makes up the pair is in the top layer. Then, to get these pieces back into one of those eight setups that I've been talking about, all you have to do is the inverse of the moves that you just did. For example, here I would do the inverse of each trigger and look for the resulting cases. For instance, doing R, U prime, R prime gives this case. I will then take note of where the pieces are and how they're oriented, and also remember the inverse of what trigger I did to set up the pieces in this way. In this case, R, U prime, R prime is the inverse of R, U, R prime. So to set up these pieces, all I have to do is R, U, R prime. Then I can easily insert this pair from here. Here's another example from the same last layer. Doing the inverse of a sledgehammer, which is f, r prime, f prime, r, you can see that we get this case. Again, take note of the position and orientation of these pieces, as well as the fact that we need to do a sledgehammer to pair them up. However, it's not very obvious that doing a sledgehammer actually pairs these pieces up, but of course it does. There are quite a few other, not so obvious, but still very efficient solutions to FTL cases that you can find using this method. While you're looking for solutions to cases in this way, take note of how the pieces move and how they pair up. Don't just look at this as a way for finding the algorithms to an FTL case, but rather as a way to become familiar with FTL and the formation of pairs. It should begin to make sense to you just how and why the pieces form a pair when doing these triggers. Experiment with this and take your time. Some of the solutions you will find will be very obvious to you, some you will already know, but some, even if you are very familiar with FTL, will be new to you and can be extremely useful during solves. On the other hand, if you're looking for the solution to a specific case, you can do the complete opposite of this. Set up that case, then simply try every trigger from each of the four last layer positions, and look for the trigger and last layer position combinations that set up the pieces such that you can then easily insert them. Those were a lot of words, but I'm just going to try to show you an example. So for here, you can see that we have this case. So I'm looking for a solution to this case, so I'm going to try every trigger. So I'm going to do that. Now, this comes up with a good case because it sets it up, so then I can easily insert it like that. So I'm going to take note of that, right? So I know from here, I can go like this to split up these pieces, and then I can insert them easily. Okay, so I take note of that, and I also take note of where this pair is. So where in the last layer it is, that is. So continuing, try each trigger. Make sure to do the mirrors of all these triggers as well. So I'm not going to go through every trigger or anything, but I think you get the idea. So just try everything, go here. Some things you'll know are very obvious won't give you anything. You can see like going like this just preserves that so it won't do anything. You don't have to do this arbitrarily. Just choose ones that you think might work and just experiment with it like that. But what about cases in which neither piece that makes up a pair is in the top layer? As I've already mentioned, for these cases you must do one of the triggers, which sets up a case in which both pieces are in the top layer. Then you must simply solve the resulting case as you normally would. For these cases, I would suggest you try the second method for finding solutions. That is, you set up a specific case that you're having trouble with, then simply try each of the triggers and look for the ones that result in the best cases. The best triggers to do for these cases are generally the ones that split them up, so like this and also this. While I believe learning solutions to FTL cases in these ways are better, as they give you more insight into how pairs are formed and can be manipulated, which prove very important in more advanced FTL techniques such as multi-slotting, I understand that some people may prefer to simply learn the algorithms for each case. Whether that is true or you just can't find a good solution to a particular case, I find the Speed Solving Wiki page on FTL to be a very useful resource for this and something I highly recommend you check out. So that is all for this video. If you found it helpful, please like this video, check out my channel, and look out for the upcoming videos in the series. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.